Hi everyone, this is your Tampa Bay Realtor Lance Moore, and in this video I'm going to go over how to make an offer on a home. So I'm going to tell you a true story and what happens so you know what not to do when you make an offer on a home, and then we're going to go over what you need to do when you make an offer on a home. So I wanted to go over from a seller and a listing agent's perspective on an offer that I got from a real estate agent and a buyer, talk a little bit about that so you know what not to do, and then we're going to go over a little bit about what you need to do when you make an offer on a home. And this is something that just happened. So here's what happened. I listed the home for $199,900. It was a little on top of the end, but I know all the buyers from 280 to 300 or just going up to 300,000. So we priced the home for about a week, maybe a little over 10 days at $299,900. And we ended up lowering it to 294. So we get an offer in at 270. Now this was a real low offer that really didn't justify anything. It was just real low. But the problem is when the agent sent over the offer, they didn't even present the offer. They basically just sent the offer through an email. They sent the offer in the pre-qualification letter. I never got a call. I never got a text. I never got anything. And then I look at the tagline of the Realtor and it says over 20 years in business, over 1,200 homes sold. And I thought to myself, really, you can't even call me up. So whatever. I looked over the contract, looked over the pre-qualification. I called my client, talked to him a little bit. We weren't really that close, or if we were, I would have contacted the lender. So I wanted to see where we were. I talked to my seller, and he was at. He said he wanted to be at 288, but he'd go down to 280. And I called up the other agent. It hit his voicemail and his voicemail box was full. So I emailed him. I sent over the offer at $288,000. I didn't hear from him. I didn't hear from him that day. I wasn't hearing from him the next day. So I reached out to him. I ended up emailing him again. I did not hear from him a second time. And then the third time, the next day, I was going to email him and I got a call, or I got an email back from him, just said, my buyer decided not to move forward with the home. It's just the buyer and seller are too far apart. So I emailed him back and I said, why don't you tell your buyer to just present their final offer and what they want the home for, and maybe we could get this worked out. And I never have heard from him since. I've actually tried calling his mobile. The voicemail box is full. So here's the thing. When you're working with a real estate agent and you're making an offer on a home, have them present the offer. Have them handle themselves with a certain amount of professionalism and a certain amount of knowledge. They're getting paid to do this. I just can't imagine in over 20 years in business, I have never, ever, not once, just sent an offer over without reaching out and contacting the other agent. So he should have reached out and contacted me, and one, just made sure I have the offer. And then two, he should have never advised his client, and it could have been his client that said it, but to say, well, let's just not do anything, we're too far apart. Because you never know. If they would have went up to 280, the buyer would have got a really nice home for the price. So not returning phone calls, having a voicemail box filled up, not going back as a buyer, and at least given the opportunity, if you like the home, to do the buy at the highest and best. These are things that you need to look into. You need to look at your real estate agent for advice, but if your agent's not giving you that advice, sometimes you just need to take the bull by the horns and just tell them what you want to do. And the main thing is just the professionalism over on the other agent's side, not calling, not returning calls, or I should say emails, because his voicemail box was full. Having a voicemail box that's full all the time. I even text the agent, not a reply back, just nothing. So even if he came back and he decided to come back in the next few days, the seller was already pretty upset. And I was like, man, what an unprofessional real estate agent, handling himself like this. So get a professional real estate agent that knows what they're doing. Make sure they're presenting the offer. Because sometimes if an agent sends a contract just by email, It could go into a junk folder. I've actually had buyers where I didn't present their offer because it went into my junk folder. I never got a call from the agent. We had multiple bids and the deal was wrapped up. And I'm just sitting there thinking, email is not a really solid form of communication. With something as important as a contract and other important documents, you need to be calling the other agent. You need to be texting them and giving them a heads up. So I hope this video helped. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to reach out to me. If you're in the Tampa Bay area, I would love to talk to you. I'd love to work with you. And if you, again, if there's any videos you want me to do, any questions you have, leave them in the comments below and I could do one. All right, have a wonderful day and best of luck buying a home.